Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Up to this point, we have discussed how, when magnetic flux through a loop changes, electric current is induced in the loop. What we haven't yet discussed is how the magnetic field then interacts with the new induced current. That is what we are about to learn about. Realize, an induced current is a bunch of charge carriers which are moving in a magnetic field. That induced current, those moving charges, can also now have induced forces acting on them as a result of the fact that they are charges moving in a magnetic field. The magnetic force on a current-carrying wire equals the cross product of current times the length vector of the wire and the magnetic field. This equation is for when the current is constant, the wire is straight, and the magnetic field is uniform and constant. And we also have the magnitude of the magnetic force equation. We're not going to concern ourselves with the integral form of the magnetic force equation right now because we are only going to look at straight wires and uniform constant magnetic fields, because what I'm really interested in making sure you understand right now concerns the directions of the induced magnetic forces on induced currents.
Can we do an example?
Yes, Billy. Let's do an example.
Goody. I love examples.
In our example, we have a front view and a side view of a conducting loop in the shape of a rectangle. Basically, we have a wire rectangle in the shape of a picture frame, and that conducting wire loop is oriented like this. In the front view, you can see there is a uniform magnetic field which is coming toward you. In the side view, the uniform magnetic field is going to your left, and the rectangular conducting wire loop is oriented like this. Again, the front view looks like this, with the uniform magnetic field coming toward you. And in the side view, the uniform magnetic field is going to your left. Now, I am about to talk about a lot of directions, and every direction I will be referencing will reference the front view. Again, every direction I'm about to mention is in the perspective of the front view.
I think we get it, Mr. P.
Yeah, right now you think that.
Yep.
Okay. The uniform magnetic field, which is out of the screen, is decreasing in magnitude. Billy, what does that mean for the direction of the induced current in the rectangular loop?
A uniform magnetic field is out of the screen and decreasing. That means the magnetic flux through the loop is decreasing. Lenz's law tells us the induced magnetic field opposes that change in magnetic flux. Therefore, the induced magnetic field inside the loop is out of the screen. Using the alternate right-hand rule, I'm already limbered up, fingers curl with the induced magnetic field inside the loop, which is out of the screen. Thumb points counterclockwise with the induced current in the loop. The induced current in the loop is counterclockwise from the front view perspective.
Thanks, Billy. Now, to talk about the induced magnetic forces on the induced current in all four sides of this rectangular conducting loop, let's give each side a number. Side 1 is on the top, side 2 is on the right, side 3 is on the bottom, and side 4 is on the left. Please notice I have not given each of the currents in all four sides of the loop subscripts because they all have the same magnitude current. It is the induced current caused by the decreasing magnetic flux through the loop. Bo, please use the right-hand rule to determine the directions of the induced magnetic forces caused by the induced currents in this uniform magnetic field. And again, every direction referred to right now is still in the front view.
Sure. Side 1 has current going to the left, so point the fingers of my right hand to the left. I, too, am already limbered up.
And clearly not too cool.
Duh. Side 1, pointing fingers to the left with the current, fingers curl out of the screen with the magnetic field, thumb points up in the direction of the induced magnetic force on side 1 caused by the induced current passing through side 1, which is in a magnetic field.
Thanks. And the other three sides?
Okay. For side 2, fingers point up with the current, curl fingers out of the screen with the magnetic field. Thumb points to the right in the direction of the induced magnetic force on side 2. For side 3, fingers with current to the right, curl out of the screen with magnetic field. Thumb points down with magnetic force on side 3. For side 4, fingers point down with current, curl out of the screen, Thumb points left with magnetic force on side 4.
Thank you, Bo. Now, Billy, please determine the net force caused by all the induced magnetic forces on the rectangular loop.
How do I do that? I mean, we don't have any numbers.
Interesting. So, Billy, are you telling me you have a numbers dependency?
I do not have a numbers dependency. It's just,
Start by looking at just sides 1 and 3.
Oh, okay. The induced magnetic forces on sides 1 and 3. Okay, the magnitude of the induced magnetic force equals the current times the length of the wire times the magnitude of the magnetic field times the sine of the angle between the two. For sides 1 and 3, all of those values are the same. The currents are the same, the lengths of the wires are the same, the magnitudes of the magnetic fields are the same, and the angles are the same. And the directions of the magnetic forces are opposite to one another. That means the net induced magnetic force on sides 1 and 3 of the rectangle equals 0. And the same is true for sides 2 and 4. The current has the same magnitude, the lengths of the wires are the same, the magnetic field has the same magnitude at the locations of both sides 2 and 4, and the sine of the angle for sides 2 and 4 gives the same value. So the net induced magnetic force for sides 2 and 4 is also 0. And then that means that the net induced magnetic force on the entire rectangular loop equals 0. No numbers needed.
Nice.
Very nice. The net induced magnetic force on this current carrying loop in a uniform magnetic field is 0. Now, let's switch from the front view to the side view again. This represents the rectangular loop in the front view, and this represents the rectangular loop in the side view. Bobby, please walk through the directions of the current and induced magnetic forces on all four sides of the rectangular loop, only now in the side view.
Yeah, I can do that. In the side view, the current through side one is into the screen, and the induced magnetic force on side 1 is up. The current through side 2 is up and to the right, and the induced magnetic force on side 2 is out of the screen. The current through side 3 is out of the screen, and the induced magnetic force on side 3 is down. The current through side 4 is down and to the left, and the induced magnetic force on side 4 is into the screen. Okay, I think I see what you are getting at. While the net force caused by the induced magnetic forces on the rectangular loop equals 0, there is actually a non-zero net torque on the rectangular loop. The net induced magnetic force on the loop does not cause a translational acceleration of the loop. However, the induced magnetic force causes a net torque on the loop, which can cause an angular acceleration of the loop. That's pretty cool.
Yes, that is pretty cool. In this example, assuming the loop is not attached to anything, the net torque on the loop would cause an angular acceleration around its center of mass, which is counterclockwise in the side view perspective at this specific moment in time.
The loop would have a force of gravity acting downward, causing a downward translational acceleration. Right?
I think this is all theoretical right now, and he's ignoring the force of gravity acting on the loop.
He is.
Sure. That's fine.
Now, let's change the example by making it so the magnetic field ends abruptly partway through the loop. As you can see, in the front view, the magnetic field only exists inside roughly the left half of the rectangular loop. Again, the magnetic field is uniform, directed out of the screen, and decreasing in magnitude. Lenz's law gives us the same counterclockwise direction in the front view for the induced current in the loop. Bo, please, again, determine the directions of the magnetic forces on the four sides of the conducting rectangle.
Sure. Well, let's actually start with side 2, because side 2 is not in a magnetic field, so there is no induced magnetic force on side 2. Everything is the same for side 4. The induced magnetic force on side 4 is to the left. For sides 1 and 3, the directions of the magnetic forces are the same as before. Side 1 is up, side 3 is down. However, the length of the wires inside the magnetic field has decreased. Therefore, the magnitudes of the induced magnetic forces are also decreased. But those two forces are still of equal magnitude and still cancel one another out. So the net induced magnetic force on this entire loop is no longer zero. The net induced magnetic force on this loop is to the left, so this loop would accelerate to the left.
Correct, Bo. Thanks. And we can now give the general statements that the net induced magnetic force on a current-carrying loop, which is entirely in a uniform external magnetic field, always equals zero. However, those induced magnetic forces can cause a net torque on the loop. And the net induced magnetic force on a current-carrying loop, which is only partially in a uniform magnetic field, is non-zero. And this non-zero net induced magnetic force can cause a translational acceleration of the loop. And thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.